There are many options to make the exterior of our building more realistic, such as tree objects. These GDL objects have similar parameter settings as other objects. The advantage is that their visibility on the different views works just like any other element. However, the 3D representation might generate too many polygons if detailed leaves and branches are set. Nevertheless, since the energy performance of the model is to be evaluated with EcoDesigner Star, the shading effect of these modeled environmental elements can be taken into consideration, for example, when calculating solar irradiation. 2D bitmaps. These are image-like elements, mostly used for renderings and the most realistic 2D representations. 2D graphical symbols. These are simplified representations of elements used for 2D documentation only. Considering the aspects above, we will now place 2D graphical symbols only on the floor plan. Later on, when rendering in 3D, these will not be visible, so we can place 2D bitmap images for better visualization into the 3D view directly. The bitmap images placed into the 3D view will not be visible on the floor plan views. Open ground floor from the pop-up navigator or from the tab bar. Select the object tool in the toolbox and open its settings dialog. Search for tree. Select tree plan from the list. Display the categories and properties panel. Select non-load-bearing element for structural function, exterior for position, and building element proxy for element classification. Select the site and landscape terrain layer. Click OK. Zoom out if necessary and place some trees around the building. Feel free to change the style and size of the trees. Please note, trees and other complex shaped elements may contain a large number of polygons, which can increase the processing time of the building model. If this problem occurs, it's recommended to set a simplified 3D appearance and hide the element's layer in all model views where not needed. Also, note that surface recognition works for all elements. This way, 3D trees can be automatically placed at the correct elevation on the mesh. In this chapter, you furnished the building with GDL objects, made custom profiles, and created special railings. You also added an external library to the project and learned the options of the representation of the external environment.